Welcome students on today's lecture on design of water tank. So in the previous lecture, we have given the dimensions for the water tank. So this was the question, design a circular tank with a flexible base for a capacity of 5 lakh liters. The depth of the water is to be 4 meter. Freeboard 200 mm, use M20 grade concrete and grade 1 mild steel. Permissible direct tensile stress in concrete was 1.2 Newton per mm square. Permissive stress in direct tension was 100 Newton per mm square. Sketch the details. So this was the given data which we noted down. Then this was the permissible stress and this was the dimensions which we have. We also found out the dimension of the base slab as well as the tank wall. So the diameter was 12.6 meter. Then we designed the hoop tension and the steel reinforcement by providing 20 mm diameter bars at 118 mm per center to center. Thickness of tank wall, we found out the thickness of tank wall by this formula. So we arrived at 188.7. So we kept it at 180 mm thick tank wall. We can also round it up to 200 mm if you want. Reinforcement provided in the tank wall was, after the calculation, we came across that 10 mm diameter at 135 mm center to center. Then tank floor slab, that is, you can see here, the base slab, this is nothing but the floor slab, has to be designed. So for this, we have designed it at use 80 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center to center in both the direction. Okay, so let us see. So in the previous class, we have stopped at the reinforcement in the thickness of the tank wall. So thickness of the tank wall is given by the formula WHD divided by 2000 T plus M minus 1. AST sigma CT. So T working out to be 188.7 mm. Thickness of tank wall, we took it as 180 mm. Reinforcement in the tank wall by providing 0.3% minimum reinforcement. So 0.3 divided by 100 into the dimension, 1000 into 190, 5 cm square. So using 20 mm diameter pass, so spacing is working out to be 550 mm. So minimum spacing should be greater than 3 times of the thickness of the wall. So 3 into 190, 570 mm. So add up 20 mm diameter hoops at 550 centers at the top, spacing at the depth of 2 meter below the top. So there nothing but this height will change. I will substitute as 2. So which is AST is equal to WHD divided by 2 into divided by 100. So 0.5 into 10 into 2 into 12.6 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 100, which is working out to be 1260. So spacing of 20 mm diameter bar. So 1000 into pi by 4 into d square, so the pi by 4 into d square is 20 mm. So this is working out to be 314 divided by 1260 mm. So 250 mm at center to center. So distribution and temperature reinforcement is provided in vertical direction. So area of vertical steel 0.3%. So 0.3 divided by 100 into 1000 into 180, 5 cm square. So using 10 mm diameter pass. So this is nothing but this come pi by 4 into 10 square. So it is working to 137 mm. So using 10 mm diameter bar at 130 mm center to center. Then tank floor slab providing nominal thickness of 150 mm. Minimum area of steel 0.3 divided by 100 into 150 into 1000, 450 mm square in each direction. Provide nominal half the reinforcement near the end face, which is 225 mm square. So spacing of 8 mm diameter bars. So this is another pi by 4 into 8 square, which is working out to be 220 mm. So use 8 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center to center in both the direction on each base. Now this is how the reinforcement looks like. You can see here. So this is the base slab here and this is the wall. So if you see the cross section, you can see here, this is the tank wall. This is the base slab. This is the diameter, which is 12.16. And this is 4 meter height, depth of water, 0.2 freeboard. So we have worked out on thickness of the wall, base slab as well. So this is how reinforcement is to be provided. Let us see in the tank walls. So tank wall, the dimension thickness was 190 mm. And the total depth is, total depth is 4 meter plus 0.2, 4.2 meter. So here you can see, up to so much portion, we have provided hoop steel, which is of 20 mm diameter at 1.8 center to center. So this portion from year to year, we have provided hoop steel, that is up to the 2 meters. Then in between here, 20 mm diameter at 250 mm center to center, and above at the top 20 mm diameter 550 cm. Because as the pressure will be maximum at the below portion, so the spacing is lesser. So as we go up, the spacing has been increased. So this is how the main reinforcement and the distribution reinforcement is placed. Here we have the base slab. So the base slab is of 150 mm thickness. So here you can see, here we have provided 8 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center, as well as this is the other reinforcement. So here there is a connection given between the tank wall and the water tank. So that is joint sealing, that is bitumen component. And again the base slab of again one thickness of layer is given, that is 70 mm, which is the layer of tar, and this is the layer of M concrete, and this is the base slab. So this is how the cross section is. So this will be the cross section. So this I have shown it as half section. If you see the cross section from here to here, that is, it is cut half. So similar mirror image will come. That means the same mirror image will come on this side continuing. So it is showing like this half section. This represents the half section. Okay. So thank you. So this is the end of design of circular water tank. In the next class, we will see the design of circular water tank with a fixed base. This was the design of circular water tank with flexible base. That is the way the layer of bitumen has come in. Okay. Thank you.